So hello and very good morning, dear students. Let us begin with a new session. So by now, I hope you all have understood that the caste we are born into, the religions that we practice, the class background we come from, whether we are a male or a female, are the things that determine that some people are treated, why some people are treated unequally. Om Prakash Valmiki and the Ansaris being treated unequally on the basis of differences of caste and religion. So wasn't that a very unjust thing? Yes. So now in the next topic, we are going to see about dignity. So the topic is recognizing dignity. So the first thing that I want to tell you is, what is dignity? So dignity here can be defined as the state or quality of being worthy of honor or respect. It can also be defined as one's self-respect or self-esteem. So here, for example, there is a scene from the film Deewar, which was released in 1975. The pictures are also there in your textbook. I have used the same picture so you can link it well. So this is the first picture wherein you see the small boys are polishing shoes just to earn their bread and butter. The second picture, it shows that after the shoe polishing is done, these men just throw some money at the boy. But then the boy has a lot of self-respect. He wants to be treated with a lot of dignity because he is working to earn his bread. He is not just doing a robbery or just stealing things to survive. So he is working hard. And then so he says, "I polish your shoes, sir. I don't beg. Pick up the coin and hand it to me." Right, whenever someone wants to give you something, you also feel that it should be handed over properly to you instead of just being thrown. So that is the self-esteem. And then finally, the man realizes his mistake and he picks up the coin and gives it to the child. So you can just watch that particular scene from the movie so you understand what I want to tell you. So this is all about dignity, and we also feel that when we heard the story about Om Prakash Valmiki as well as the Ansaris, their dignity was hurt, right? So their self-respect, their dignity, everything was hurt when they were treated in such a bad manner. Now let us move equality in our Indian democracy. As we said, equality plays a very important role. So what are certain provisions our democracy or our constitution has given us? It says that every person is equal. This means that every individual in the country, including male and female persons from all castes, communities, religion, educational backgrounds or economic backgrounds, are recognized as equal. So this is the book of a constitution. And then there are certain provisions made in a constitution under the article 15. So what are those? Equality before law. So this article deals with equality itself. So this is the first statement. If you remember, I have discussed this part in the fundamental rights. The next, you have no person can be discriminated against on the basis of their caste, religion, race, sex or place of birth. So now what is race over here, children? So race means a group of people identified as distinct from other groups because of physical or genetic traits shared by the group. Right? So racism we discussed in the first slide where I showed you a picture with two different skin colors. So that could be said as racism. Then we have the third provision, that is every person has access to all public places, including playgrounds, shops, market. Everyone can use public wells, roads and bathing ghats. So now what are bathing ghats? So bathing ghats are a broad flight of steps. Those are situated on an Indian river bank and that provides access to the water, especially for bathing. So if you remember, just recollect the image of the Great Bath. So in the Great Bath also you could see there were steps leading towards the bathing area. So similarly, these are the steps which lead you to the river bank. So those are the bathing ghats. And finally, we have untouchability is abolished. Now, we don't use the term Dalits or untouchables. It has been abolished from our constitution. Now, the next part we have is the other provisions. So there are different other provisions as well. These we have done only under the fundamental right of equality. Now let us see what are the other provisions. So the other provisions are, people are getting equal opportunity for public employment, abolition of titles. We remember there were certain titles given to our freedom fighters and all. So those titles no more exist. Now we don't give any titles to people. The next we have equality through welfare schemes. So now we have been talking about unequal status, people are treated on the basis of their religion, caste and so on. But then a government is also making certain provisions, or we can say the welfare scheme. So just go through it, we'll just go through it. What are these welfare schemes? So these are some important steps. The first we have is the midday meal scheme. Then we have the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, which we discussed in the first session about RTE, what we have discussed. Then we also have Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. And also we have the National Rural Health Mission. So these are certain welfare schemes wherein the government is trying to bridge the gap between the society. So now, while government programs play a very important role in the increasing equality of opportunity, there is much that still needs to be done. Though government is bringing in such different schemes, we have to play our role. So many things we have to do for our society. So now, let us discuss more about the midday meal scheme. So what does this picture tell us? So this picture tells us that the school children are having lunch together, and if you can see, they all are having the same food items and the same kinds of plates, right? So yes, the midday meal scheme provides free lunch in government schools. It is through government free of cost lunch provided to the students. Okay, so let's discuss more about the midday meal scheme. So it is one of the important steps for promoting equality. It is said so because it has actually helped in bridging the gap between people in the society. Tamil Nadu was the first state to introduce this scheme in the year 2001. There are some advantages of this program as well. So let us see. Promoting and improving school attendance. This is actually helped many schools because government is providing one-time free meal and people have started enrolling their children, maybe not for the purpose of studies, but at least they will get proper one-time meal in the school. And sometimes, as we know, that if the schools were nearby, the students used to go home to have their lunch, but after lunch they would never come back to attend the classes. So this has also stopped because of the midday meal scheme. The next we have preventing classroom hunger and ensuring healthy growth of children. That means if the children are hungry, they cannot concentrate in the class. And then there are people from different classes or different economic classes. And then the people who are from the lower economic class, they actually struggle for one time meal as well. So this scheme has helped in that. So they at least have a one time full meal, and so they can concentrate on their work. Then it helped in reducing caste discrimination because people from different communities are appointed to cook these meals, and all the children in the school whatever may be their caste, religion, gender, they have the meals together. And then finally, it also ensures that the children get a healthy diet every day, right? Because they actually provide a good kind of meal, fine. So I hope you all have understood whatever we have completed today. If not, when we meet for the next session, you can ask me your queries, your doubts. So till then, bye, take care, have a nice day, and yes, stay safe, stay at home.